From 4 o'clock today over on More 4, it's burning hot. It's a double bill of a place in the sun. Here, well, it's almost 3:25, so not long for countdown. 9 tonight on Channel 4, 10 tonight on Channel 4 Plus 1. A grand design that might just end up looking like a car showroom. Kevin, help.
Don't forget, recording equipment will also need to be ready for the digital switchover.
Afternoon countdown is everywhere. I do like the curtain rings.
Do you like very big curtains? It's very 60s, this, you see. Do you remember girls when they used to wear with the white patent leather boots?
Yeah.
It just came almost up to the knee, didn't they? And then.
They're steady, oh, girl. They are very nice, Carol. Nice to see you in a frisky mood today. Right, here's a... Kath and Len seem to be sending more emails than anybody, and they send them from Spain, so thank you, Kath and Len. Now, a man walks into a restaurant with a full-grown ostrich behind him. And he,
like you do.
Yeah, like you do.
Hey, was silly. That wearing white patent leather boots?
No, he wasn't. He had no curtain rings, just a straight ostrich. Right? And he sits down. The waitress comes over and asks for their order. The man says, I'll have a hamburger, chips and a Coke, and turns the ostrich, what's yours? He says, I'll have the same. This is stupid, isn't it? A short time later, the waitress returns with the order. That will be £10.50, please. And the man reaches into his pocket and pulls out the exact change for payment. The next day, the man and the ostrich come in again. He says, I'll have hamburger, chips and a Coke. The ostrich says, I'll have the same. Once again, the man reaches into his pocket and pays with the exact change. This becomes a routine until late one evening. They enter again.
Yeah, the man and the ostrich.
Yes.
In the boots.
Usual, ask the waitress, no, this is Friday night, he says. So I'll have a steak, baked potatoes and salad. And the ostrich says, same for me. A short time later, the waitress comes with the order and that will be £25.52. Once again, the man pulls the exact change out of his pocket and places it on the table.
Yeah.
The waitress can't hold back her curiosity. Excuse me, how do you manage to always come up with the exact change out of your pocket every time? Well, several years ago, I was cleaning the attic. I found an old lamp. When I rubbed it, up popped a genie, offered me two wishes. My first wish was that if I ever had to pay for anything, I would have just put my hand in my pocket and the right amount of change would
wish.
Always be there.
Yeah.
It's good, this, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's practically a book, but it's good. That's brilliant, said the waitress. Most people would wish for $1 million or something, but you'll always be as rich as you want for as long as you live. That's right, whether it's a gallon of milk or a Rolls Royce, the exact money is always there, says the man. Though he said, just one thing, sir, what's with the ostrich? The man sighs, pauses and answers, my second wish was for a tall chick with long legs who agrees with everything I say. Very nice, you two in Spain. A little shorter next time. That's practically half the programme gone. Yeah. Right, let's have a look at our play. We know David now. David, this is his fifth show today, isn't it? Fifth show?
Fifth show, yeah.
So you're on your way upwards towards the Octo Champ. You've got to beat this young lady. And this is Hazel Wheeler, and from Wolverhampton in the West Midlands. Originally, you're a Dagenham girl, Essex girl.
Dagenham girl, Essex girl, that's me, yep.
Did you ever wear the white court shoes?
I had the white patent leather boots when I used to go to 60s weekends.
Yeah. And you dance around your handbag.
Oh, I've been accused of that before, yep.
Yeah, and you're wearing, the earrings you're wearing are from my belt,
yes.
Aren't they? Yeah.
They're slightly different colour.
Yeah.
It's all mad today, isn't it? It's all mad. Nice to have you here. We wish you both luck today. That's Hazel and David playing our game today.
Well, he is, in fact, one of the longest-serving incumbents of Dictionary Corner. Yes, he joined us in 1995 on his 65th birthday, which was lovely of him, and he's been with us ever since. Yes, sitting next to the lovely Alison Hurd, please welcome the Dictionary Daddy of them all, Richard Dytens.
Yeah, We've got a nickname for you now.
Dickie
Digents, yeah. We call you.
Really?
Well, I've called him worse. Believe me.
All right, let's play the game, shall we? So, David, you're going to start with the first set of letters, please.
Hello, Carol. Vial, please.
A vowel. Right, we start then, both of you, with E.
Vial.
O.
And a third vowel.
And I.
Consonant.
J.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
Y.
Consonant.
H.
Another consonant, please.
F.
And I'll finish with a consonant.
And that is S.
And here's the first clock. Right, how do we start there, David?
Six.
Six. And you, Hazel?
Six.
Six. Let's ladies go first.
Fished.
Fished. Yep. They both fished. Right. Yep. Well, you started, so I'm sure that's correct. And what have you got there, young Richard?
Your missus is in them letters, isn't she?
Jodie's. I looked at that as well. Yeah. Everything is Jodie's. Yeah, well spotted, well spotted. Yeah. What else have you got?
Little Joey's, the little kangaroos, but that's only five.
Yeah. All right. Well, we've got a level pegging start here. Both our players got 6 points on the board. So, Hazel, it's your turn now with the letters.
I'll have a consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you, Hazel. T.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another vowel.
A.
And another vowel, please.
U.
And a consonant.
C.
And another one, please.
G.
And another vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant.
D.
And another consonant, please.
And R.
Right, here's a clock. Hazel, how did we go there?
Seven.
Seven, that's good. And David?
Eight.
Eight, right. Let's have the seven then.
Grouted.
Grouted, yes. And the eight?
Educator.
Educator.
Yeah,
that's a very good one.
Very good.
Two good words. Two good words from our players. What have we got over there then?
Is there another eight?
There is actually. Yeah, they could have had outraced.
Outraced?
Outraced is there to
that's
run faster than someone else.
Right, we're all scoring good points right away. We're going to ask David this time to pick some letters, if you would, David.
Can I have a vowel, please?
Thank you, David. I.
Another vowel.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant, please.
M.
Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
B.
Another consonant, please.
S.
Consonant.
N.
And a final consonant.
And B.
And here's a clock. David?
Just six.
Just six that time. And Hazel?
Five.
Five. Not easy, this lot. Let's have the five.
Basin.
Basin, yes. And the six.
Babies.
Babies, yeah.
Yeah, fine.
So, anything from the corner? Anything else?
No.
No. Now, I'm sure you could come up with something,
yeah,
young Richard.
Yeah, we've struggled with this one, haven't we?
Yeah, we did find another six, which is Pie Man.
Pie Man.
Yeah.
Right, David's got 20, Hazel's got six, and Hazel is going to choose these letters.
A vowel, please, Carol.
I.
And another one.
E.
And a third one, please.
E.
And a consonant.
L.
And another one, please.
M.
And another.
S.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another consonant, please.
N.
And another one.
And finally, H.
And here's a clock. Have Hazel.
Five again,
Dave.
Six.
Let's have the five.
Slime.
And the six?
Melons.
Melons. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. What have you got there, Richard?
There's an eight, actually, Des.
Eight?
Yeah, it's something that I don't encounter much these days. Hemlines.
Hemlines. Yep. Excellent. Okie doke. What's happening on the scoreboard? David's galloping away. He's got 26. Hazel's got 6. It is numbers time. Carol takes her hemline over to the board. What do you have a go, David?
What do you require from the numbers tray, Mr. David O'Donnell?
I think you know what I want. Four large, please.
The Motown selection.
The Motown, yeah.
The four tops, basically, is the Motown selection. And then two from anywhere else.
Yeah, please.
Thanks, David.
You're welcome.
Right, we have 3 and 2. Those are the little numbers. 25, 75, 150, with a target of, 992.
And here's a clock. David.
Messed it up a bit. I'm stuck in 1,000.
You've got what?
1,000.
1,000. What about you, Hazel?
Nothing at all, I'm afraid.
Nothing at all.
Complete
so
blank.
This sounds like it's a difficult one, Carol. We've got 8 away, so we're going to have David's version of that.
It is.
100 plus 50.
Yeah, 100 plus 50.
Times 3.
The 2 times the 2.
3, yeah. And then
multiplied
add on.
By the 6 is 900.
And then add on the 25. And then.
Yeah, exactly what I did that. 1,000.
Okie doke. David's got 31, though, and Hazel's got 6, so he picked up a few points there. As we welcome young Dickie Dyden to the show.
Yeah, this is a story about a bloke and an ostrich. Twelve years ago, as Carol was saying when I started Countdown, myself and Mr. Whiteley and Carol got involved with a load of why questions that became very, very fashionable at that time. You know, why, blah, 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 blah. And over the years, lots of people use them and stuff. And I thought, going back to sort of how it began for me on Countdown 12 years ago, I thought I'd do some why questions this week, and I'm going to do 100.
100 why questions?
I could do 20
That's
a day.
Longer than the ostrich joke.
It is longer than the ostrich. And also, Carol likes things to think about. She likes my thoughts. So I'm going to start every day this week with a few thoughts for you guys and for Carol, and then I'm going to go into my little why questions, all right?
Yes.
So some of them you know, some of them you won't know. OK, thoughts for the day. On Noah's Ark, where did Noah put the two woodpeckers? You see, there are people thinking, what's that all about? Don't matter, forget it. How many rabbits were on the Ark after 40 days and nights? If love is blind, how can there be love at first sight? That's quite good, isn't it?
Good point.
How can you draw a blank? And did they have antique shops 100 years ago? Okay, wise. Why do golfers wear such ridiculous clothes?
Yeah.
Have you noticed that?
They are a bit garish.
And shout 4 instead of watch out on the course. Why isn't there a Salvation Navy? And why not a Salvation Air Force? Why don't mobile homes have wheels? Why doesn't money grow on trees? be nice. Why don't they have a minute's noise when a librarian dies? Why do you close your eyes when you sneeze? And why isn't marmalade called orange jam? Why do you kick your tyres when you're buying a car? Why don't airlines give you a parachute instead of a life jacket? And why aren't hearts called pumps? Because that's what they are. Why is Newcastle called Newcastle when all castles are old? Why are apartments joined together? Why is it called a near miss when two planes nearly collide? Yes. And why is it always Scottish people reading the weather? Always, isn't it? Why do numbers on a phone go downwards, but on a calculator they go up?
Yeah.
It's quite interesting. Why is there thick, dense, but not stupid fog? Why was Mickey Mouse, who was after all just a mouse, bigger than Pluto the dog? Why is it impossible to lick your own elbow or tickle yourself? Why don't sheep shrink in the rain? Today, I've given you 20 why questions, and tomorrow there'll be more of the same.
Oh, we like those. Very nice, Richard. Very nice, very funny. Right, the words are dirt, D-I-R-T, dirt sled, S-L-E-D, and the clue, think bigger and put these back. Think bigger and put these back.
The countdown to the TV switchover has begun.
Join the fun at mirrorbingo.com from the Daily Mirror. Register today and we'll give you £10 to play absolutely free with no deposit required. Tens of thousands of pounds can be won every day. Plus, chat and make friends while you play. Join in the fun now at mirrorbingo.com.
Imagine me and you, I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right. The only one for me is you, and you for me, so happy together.
With delicious biscuit and caramel, it's Twix. Two great tasting bars, happy together.
Mum's sick. Lucy's having a sleepover.
Who'd like to do some surfing?
Yeah, great.
Here we go. Who wants to choose a film?
Yeah, all right, there are hundreds. Lovely.
Do you want to call your mum?
Now, BT Total Broadband includes BT Vision with its very own digital TV recorder. To get a more complete broadband package, call 0800 317 316.
Or is a miserable word. Or makes you choose. And is different. And says, why choose? Have both, if you like. So pick the only credit card that gives you both 0% on balance transfers and 0% on transfers to current accounts until January 2009. And 0% on purchases until April 2008. Typical 15.9% APR variable. MBNA Platinum Plus, 0800 1055 10 or visit mbna.co.uk.
I'd like a nice meal and a good dance.
Shoes. Really good going out shoes.
Fish. I'd like a fish tank, tropical fish.
Big house in the country that has an electronic gate.
I want a Lamborghini.
Perhaps a nice toy boy.
Chocolate. I like a tall man. Big feet.
It's what women want. Relax, chat and play at partybingo.co.uk. Sign up now and we'll double your deposit up to £100.
When my beautician asked me what aged me most, I was like, lines and wrinkles, blah, blah, blah. And the next thing I know, I'm having this Definity skin test and there's my skin magnified, all my dark patchy bits. And she's like, these can also put years on you. Luckily, she gave me some Definity before I got really depressed.
Olay Definity not only works on the appearance of lines and wrinkles, but fights what can age you most by also reducing the look of dark spots to give you younger looking skin.
Really chuffed.
And in a recent Woman and Home survey, 3 out of 4 readers who tried Olay Definity said they would switch from their current moisturiser. Definity from Olay. Love the skin you're in.
I shouldn't be here.
I shouldn't be here.
I shouldn't be here.
Thanks to Cancer Research UK, thousands of people are here today who wouldn't have survived 10 years ago.
My mum should be here.
Please help more people to be here. Call 0800 038 1000 and give £2 a month to Cancer Research UK.
Being torn between something that you really want to do and then knowing what you have to do, and when those two things are different, I guess it's called life. I don't know.
The best documentaries in the world, 52 weeks a year. True Stories, Tuesdays at 10 on More 4.
You need to ensure all your TVs are converted to digital.
Right, the words are dirt sled, and the clue, think bigger and put these back. Tiddlers, tiddlers, they're all
it's
the
a nice word, a little cheeky, mischievous word, that
yes,
one.
Yes, yes, it's a kind of, well, it relates to kids as well, well lots
toddler.
Of things. Toddlers, tiddlers.
Yeah.
What's happening on our board? 31 to David, Hazel got 6. We're going to go to Hazel and ask her if she will put some letters on the board, please.
A vowel, please, Carol.
E.
And another one?
I.
And another, please?
E.
A consonant, please.
L.
And another one, please.
W.
And another.
R.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And another consonant, please.
S.
And another one.
And D.
And here's that clock. What do you have?
A dodgy 6.
A dodgy 6. Mm. And over there, David?
It's
8. So let's have the dodgy 6, Hazel.
Wields.
Wheels?
Yes, that's fine.
That's
yeah,
all
no
right.
Problem.
And David, you're 8?
Realised.
Realised.
Yes, very
excellent.
Good.
Very good. Right, he keeps finding these 8s and 7s and things. What have you got there, Richard?
There's actually an anagram of realised.
Which is?
That nobody knows except Alison.
Yeah. Sidereal.
Sidereal?
Yeah, S-I-D-E-R-E-A-L. And it relates to the distant stars.
The distant stars?
Yeah. People like yourselves.
Yeah, we're not that far away. We've got a 39 playing 6 here, so it's David's turn to put some letters on the board. There you go, Dave.
I'm a file, please.
E.
File.
A.
File.
O.
Consonant, please.
T.
Consonant.
V.
Consonant.
C.
Consonant.
Z.
File, please.
E.
And a final consonant.
And N.
And here's a clock. Zed's off putting. What do you got, David?
A 7.
7. And Hazel?
4.
4, yeah. bit frustrating, that set of letters. What's your 4?
Vote.
Vote. And yours, David?
A centavo.
What was that?
Centavo.
Can you spell it?
Yeah, C-E-N-T-A-V-O.
Okay. Yeah, it's a coin, a monetary unit in Mexico.
Oh.
Very good.
Have you been to Mexico, David?
No.
I was in Mexico Christmas Day.
Were you?
Yes, I went through the Panama Canal on Christmas Day.
On a ship, I assume?
No, on a bike.
I meant working on a ship.
Yeah, sorry, mate. Yeah, I wasn't. Yeah, I was. Yeah.
All right. Anything else from the corner?
No, that's it. Octave we had, but that's nothing.
Okay, we're not going to mention the scores because Hazel doesn't want me to anymore, I don't think, for a while. We're going to go to Hazel and ask her if she will put some letters on the board, please.
A vowel, please, Carol.
Thank you, Hazel. A.
And another, please.
O.
And another vowel, please.
I.
And a consonant, please.
T.
And another.
P.
And another, please.
D.
And another vowel, please.
O.
And a consonant.
T.
And another, please.
And X.
And one more clock. That's not a thrill. What have you got, Hazel?
Four.
I'm not surprised. David?
Five.
Five. So let's have the four, Hazel.
Taxi.
Taxi and...
Patio.
Patio. Now, I dare you to get a six, Richard, from this lot.
What? Apart from potato, you mean?
Potato?
Yeah.
Ah. Okie doke. We got 51 for David and for Hazel. So just the 6 points, Hazel. But we're all rooting for you, so
thank you.
Maybe this will be your turn. David, some letters on the board, please.
A file, please.
A.
File.
E.
File.
A.
Consonant, please.
P.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
S.
And a file, please.
O.
And another vowel, please.
And E.
And here's the clock. David, what do we have?
Eight.
Eight again. And Hazel?
Seven.
Seven. Yeah. Well, let's hear the seven.
Repeats.
Repeats. And David, eight?
Operates.
Operates.
Very good.
Yeah, very good. What about the corner then, Richard?
Yeah, you got to try harder than that. Look, I'm not reading that. Ape.
Ape. Is that your contribution, eh?
There is a seven, which is seaport.
Seaport.
Yeah.
Okie doke. Right. David's got 59 and Hazel is still punching away. Let's go with the numbers board, Hazel.
See if we can... I'm sure you're a wise woman. You'll make a perfectly good selection.
Yes, well, we won't count on that. Three from the top.
Oh.
And any others of your choice, please, Carol?
Thank you, madam.
There must be something in the water we're giving you, I'll tell you. Right, here we go. 2, 4, and 9. And then the large numbers are 100, 50, and 25, with a target, a low target, 191.
And here's a clock. So, Hazel, 191?
No, I've muffed it again, I'm afraid.
All right. And David?
I think of 191.
You think you've got it?
Yeah.
Right, let's hear it.
25 minus 4.
21, yes.
Times 9. 189.
It is.
And then add the two.
Oh, right. Unusual way of doing it. Yes, there we are.
There you go.
It was.
Is there an easier way to do it?
Yeah, 2 times 100 minus 9.
I had the feeling while you were looking at it, you were dying to put.
I was thinking, why didn't they get that?
Oh my God!
All right. Okay, it's tea time, teaser time, and the word here is epicode. E-P-I-C-C-O-D-E. So epicode. Yes. Here's the clue: old-fashioned garment for fishermen. Old-fashioned garment for fishermen.
The countdown to the TV switchover has begun.
Sainsbury's have got loads of easy ways to help you towards your five a day. For a great smoothie, I get a banana, these Sainsbury's frozen summer fruits, and some apple juice. Brilliant. And try this for your pasta. Handful of spinach and these fantastic Sainsbury's chopped tomatoes. Beautiful. And even dried fruit can count. Get yourself some yoghurt, add some hot honey and chuck a load on. Go on, try something new today.
If you're starting to struggle with the stairs, it may be time you considered getting a Stanner. Here at Stanner, we've been making for over 30 years. Our latest generation of are easy to use, comfortable, and styled by award-winning designers.
We understand that talking about stair lifts isn't easy, but having one fitted can help you stay independent. Call Stanner on 0800 715 444 for a brochure.
Whatever you're buying, there's more to think about than just the price. Now, if you're over 50, it's the same with car insurance. Confident Cover is the only over 50s online comparison site. You can compare prices and more than 30 important features. So you can be confident that the one you choose suits you exactly.
It's always nice to find something a little different. Abby's new credit card gives you 0% interest on balance transfers until February 2009, as well as 0% interest on purchases for 3 months. You can even get up to £50 back on your supermarket shopping. You get more from the new Abby credit card. Visit your local branch or call 0800 80 80 80. Abby, more ideas for your money.
We can't make you immortal, and we know you don't really want to think about this. But one day, your luck could run out. We can help give your loved ones a financial safety net when that happens. We can give you life insurance from as little as £10 a month, and we can guarantee your payments will never increase, no matter how long you stick around. So, don't put it off. Call us or go online. Norwich Union. We just make it easier.
Now you can look like you've caught some sun while you fight 7 signs of aging. Because Olay has combined its age-defying moisturiser with a touch of sunless tanner. Introducing Total Effects Touch of Sunshine. Olay's first age-defying cream that gives you gradual building colour. So good, 8 out of 10 women from an Easy Living panel agreed their skin looks and feels naturally sun-kissed and smoother. New Olay Total Effects Touch of Sunshine. Fighting aging just got sunnier.
Jeff was a very busy person. Gym Mondays, swimming Wednesdays and squash every Friday. So when he hurt his elbow, he needed to get it sorted quickly. Because Jeff was with Booper, he arranged a time that fitted in with his hectic lifestyle. With Booper's help, he soon found himself in a comfy, clean hospital. He met Dr. Finn, who knew elbows inside out. Before he knew it, he was back being busy again. Booper, feel better.
More of us could have psychic powers than we think. Tonight, the university professor who may be proving clairvoyance is for real. Our daughter Chloe plays guinea pig for the cameras.
Michael Winner's here just after narrowly escaping death by first oyster and then superbug. Why millions are following in their grandparents' footsteps and emigrating en masse down under. Plus the book club, back at 5.
Look for the digital tick on any new TV equipment.
Right, the word was epicode and the clue, old-fashioned garment for fishermen. And the answer? Codpiece. Yes. Told you that word. I don't know, something.
It's a funny word.
I remember Ken Dodd. I can remember what he said. What a lovely day for sticking a packet of fish fingers in your underwear and saying, "How's that for a codpiece?" It's the sort of thing Doddy would do, isn't it? Lovely word. Okay, we're not going to go to the scores, but we know David's got 69 and Hazer's got her fingers crossed as we go to some letters from David.
A vial, please.
I.
Vial.
O.
Another vial.
A.
Consonant, please.
M.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
L.
A vial.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And that is R.
Here's a clock. How do we go there, David?
Seven.
Seven. And Hazel?
Seven.
Seven. Hazel, you go first.
Mineral.
Mineral. Yep, that's correct. And
Maureen.
What was that?
Maureen. M-O-R-A-I-N-E.
Maureen.
Maureen.
Yes, I've heard of that one. It's,
what do we think it is,
yes,
David?
It's a geological term.
I mean.
Geological.
Maureen, that's okay.
It's fine. Very good.
All right, so nice. 7 points each there. What have we got from the corner there, Richard?
There's another seven, which is almana or almana, however you choose to pronounce it. It's when, I think it's someone who sorts out when two nuts are having a row, isn't it?
Well, we'll leave it at that description. Alison may have a different one. All right. So there you go, Hazel. 13 points. So it's on the bubble. And David's got 76. He didn't get away with all of it. Hazel, you're on a roll. So let's get some letters.
A vowel, please. Carol.
A.
And another, please.
O.
And another.
I.
And a consonant, please.
M.
And another.
S.
And another one.
G.
And another vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant.
D.
And a final consonant, please.
And T.
And here's a clock. How do we go, Hazel there?
Four.
Four and David?
Eight.
Eight. Right, let's go with the four.
Dime.
Dime and the eight.
Godetias.
Could you spell that?
G-O-D-E-T-I-A-S.
Yeah, the flower.
Godetias.
Yep.
Meaning?
Flowers.
Flowers. What do you get in the corner there, Richard?
Well, beaten Hazel.
It's not difficult, is it?
We got a... Are they, haven't we?
Yes, we have, yeah. Atomised.
Yeah. Seems to turn up a lot.
Carol,
you that's turned up, what, three times over the last...
It's turned up a lot more than that. I think it was the word of 2007 and going into 2008, I think.
Yeah.
Atomised or atomizer.
Yeah, it seems to be there.
Atomic.
Not as often as cat, though, is it?
Not as often as cat.
Right. David has got 84. Hazel's got 13. We're going to have some letters from David this time.
Can I have a vial, please?
U.
Vial.
A.
Vial.
E.
Consonant, please.
L.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
N.
And consonant.
R.
Vial, please.
O.
And final consonant.
And Q.
And here's a clock. right, David. What do you get there?
Seven.
Seven. Hazel?
Five.
Five. What is your five, Hazel?
Nurse.
Nurse and?
Loaners.
Loaners.
As in bank loans.
Loaners. Yep, that's okay. And what have we got there, Richard?
Well, we didn't equal you there. No, I'm afraid. So we're only six.
Six.
Equals reason, but that was about it.
What about Queens?
Yeah, very nice, Des.
With an A?
Yeah, Q-U-E-A-N means, it's an archaic word, meaning an impudent or badly behaved girl. Like
of course
me.
I knew then. I was looking at you as I asked you, yes, exactly. What about Queens? And there's another one over there by the board. An impudent, badly behaved little girl. All right. David, you're heading towards 100. You've got 91 points, so the numbers here are very important. I know Hazel loves the numbers, don't you, Hazel?
Love them, Des, love them.
Let's get it over and done with then, Hazel. How many from the top do you want? I can offer you one, two, three or four. Hazel.
Oh, sorry. Four, please.
Four? You weren't meant to say four. You meant to say what?
Trying
just
to keep
the one
him happy.
Oh, he was looking at you. Was all right. Here we go. Eight and seven, and then 175 and 25 and 50 and 810.
And here's the clock. Right, 810, Hazel.
807.
807? Getting nearer, just the three away. David?
810.
You got 810? Okay, let's see.
8 times 100.
Yeah, Hazel's done this. 800.
75.
Plus a 7.
And.
Yeah, plus a 7. That's where Hazel got to. Is that right, Hazel?
Yeah.
Yep, thought so.
And 75 over 25.
Is the three. There we go. Add that on, 810.
Once again, you've knocked up 100. There's 101, David, this time. I like Hazel. She's a nut. I like it. She's got a little twinkle in her eye, despite this terrible uphill battle she had to fight with David. Okay, you know, it's conundrum time. Come on, Hazel. You show him. So, fingers on buzzers as we reveal today's countdown conundrum. David.
Is it clockwise?
Is it clockwise? Let's have a look and find out. It is clockwise. There you go. That makes you the winner today, David, with a score of 111.
Well done.
And sorry, Hazel, sadly, we're going to lose you. You get the goodie bag.
Oh, lovely.
You get our best wishes and give my regards to everybody in Wolverhampton.
I will do.
All right, our kid. Okay. David, you're five winners now, so you're getting nearer that Octochamp. Thing.
Yeah, hope
okay. So. And how about you today? Which is all a bit crazy today, wasn't it? It was all a bit mad.
Yeah, it was a weird one, really, wasn't it? When you walked in the studio dressed like that, I thought...
Me?
Yeah, it's not going to be right.
It's me thinking I was, you know, the Beau Brummel of Leeds today.
No, I'd never wear a blue shirt, me.
No. Can't wait to see what he's going to wear for tomorrow's countdown. See you then. You can have a look. Bye.
Well, Switchover is coming. To find out how to get digital TV and your favourite programmes like Countdown, go to channel4.com/digitalTV or select digital text page 106. Live at 5 today on 4, Michael Winner joins Richard and Judy. Next, though, a deal for a Wednesday.
Digital UK is here to help you find out when your area switches to digital TV.
with Direct Line Travel Insurance. You'll save 20% when you buy online. It pays to be with the right insurer. Call 0845 246 1635 or visit directline.com.